Hello and welcome to Hort 1080 Pest Management. My name is Gary Love. I'm your instructor for this class. I think I've taught this class maybe at least a dozen times, maybe more. And this class is one of my favorite classes. So I was in the greenhouse nursery business for a long time, like 20 something years, and pest management is always one of those key things that you need to know about when you're growing plants. If you're in the landscape business, it's another key component of that as well. What I'm going to talk in this little video about is the course itself. The course will be available tomorrow, Monday, January 8th. And this is the course layout, what it looks like for everybody. This is the home page, and on the home page you'll see a lot of announcements, including an announcement, some textbook announcement, and a welcome to Hort 1080 announcement that should have been emailed to you as well, which you'll find a lot of announcements. Now, something I've left on here, and I gotta go clean these up a little bit, but I've left a lot of announcements that I made last semester. I left them on here because there's some interesting stuff on here, like using falcons as pest control in a vineyard or mulch. You know, mulch would be like, you know, pine bark nuggets or pine straws. You know, how does that work in a pest management? Well, it's there. So I've got some interesting articles on here that I'm going to leave on here if you want to go through them and take a look at them. But I'll be posting more, you know, articles like that through the semester, just to, you know, what's new out there in pest management, you know, what's in the news and so forth on that. If you look over here on the left, okay, you got the home page, and then you've got my grades, and on my grades, you'll find all of your tests, the grades that you've made on the test. It's kind of like a report card, so to speak, on there. You'll find those here under my grades. And then the next thing, course calendar. Under here, you will see what is due each week, you know, what you're supposed to be doing. Like the January 8th, need to look at Unit 1, and I'll show you Unit 1 in just a minute. And you're going to be your reading assignments. You're going to read Chapter 1 of both the Core Manual and the Turf and Ornamental books. And I'll talk about the books in just a minute because I do have them on the course. You can download them. Also, there is a survey, what's called a no-show assignment. And no-show assignments, when you complete those, that lets me and it lets the school know that, hey, you're in the course. If you don't do the no-show assignment, we assume that you are not in the course. And the no-show assignment needs to be done by January 15th, midnight. So please have that done. It's just a survey. There's no grade on it. I'm just trying to ascertain your knowledge of the subject at hand. So you've got the no-show assignment there. And then if you look further down the calendar, you know, it's broken down by weeks. Unit 1, what is integrated pest management? That's the first 2 weeks right here. You'll be working on that. Okay, so let's see what else we got. There's course calendar, announcements. I just told you about announcements. Here's another place they live. Contact the instructor. If you have any questions, the best way to get a hold of me is by email at glove@laniertech.edu. Something else is very important. Use your student email to contact me. Do not use your personal email. Do not use your Gmail account. Use your student email. The school does not want me responding to any students except if they use their student email account. So please do that. Check your student email every day, please, because that a lot of people will miss things, very important deadlines and things like that in their student email. So please check your student email every day. Okay, I'm gonna skip this WetX video thing right here for the moment. Email, here's like a built-in email thing that's on here that you can use, or you can use your regular email. Okay, textbook information and reading assignments. Let's look at that. Hort 1080 textbooks. There are two textbooks on this class. There's the National Pesticide Applicator Certification Core Manual, and there is the UGA Special Bulletin, number 10. Okay. Both of these, for whatever reason, our bookstore, the Lanier Tech bookstore, does not sell these anymore. You can buy them from UGA, and I think in the announcement letter, I put a couple of links in there. You can very easily download this National Pesticide Applicator Core Manual. Or I've got it set up to where you can just go right here and get both of them. You can click on this, and there's all the chapters. You can download them here. And here is the ornamental and turf grass management one here. So I've got them both built into the course. You can download them here. You don't have to buy a book, okay? You just have to, you know, print them out if you need a hard copy. Now, if you want a hard copy, you can go to the UGA Extension Bookstore, and I do have a link in a couple other places for that. And if you want the link, can't find it, let me know, and I'll send it to you. So there's that. Also, let's skip over the textbook. Okay, this next section right here is your syllabus and the academic calendar, course standards and objectives. Be sure to read through these. I'll go to the syllabus here real quick because the most important thing here. You can download these. I've got it in Word format, and I've got it in an easy-to-print PDF format. Let's go here. And it's basically, what I wanted to really show you on here is you'll go through the course description, everything we do. Course grading. Okay, there are going to be 18 tests, at least one test a week. There are a few weeks where there are two tests on there, and they're multiple choice tests, nothing too hard. And then there's going to be a final exam, and the final exam is a proctored exam. You'll have to come in at the end of the course and take the exam in person, okay? So 18 tests at 5% each, one final exam at 20% each. The final exam will be made up of questions from there'll be nothing, no surprises. They're going to be made up of questions you've already had. So that was the most important thing right here. Right there, okay. All right, so read over the syllabus. Let me know if you have any questions. Right there, let me go back here to academic calendar. Here is the academic calendar. First day of class, January 8th, 2024. There's a drop add period, 8th through the 10th. Last day to withdraw without penalty is January 10th. I think that's financial. Penalty, March 11th, spring break is March 4th through 8th. March 4th through 8th. Those of you that are graduating, there's a commencement registration deadline of March 1st. Let's see what else we have right here. Okay, here's one. Last day of classes and to withdraw with a grade of W, April 29th. Okay. Last day of class is April 29th. And then final exam will probably be May 1st right there. So that's where your calendar lives right there. Let's go here. I've got this section here, pest management and learning resources. I've got several websites that you can go to. There's plant disease websites. All sorts of resources that you can use if you know you're interested in this stuff that are located here. see what else we got here. Reading assignments. Okay. Reading assignments. Okay, this is where you can easily go and download the reading assignments for each unit. Like in Unit 1, there will be some assignments to read in both books on that. So I've got them both here. You'll go here, click on that. This thing will take a second. And it'll bring up your reading assignment here. So that's one place you can find it. All right, now we'll get to, okay, here's the first assignment due January 15th. This is that survey I was talking to you about. You click on that right here, and you'll just follow the instructions. It's like a test, so to speak. All right, cancel that. Okay, that's right there. All right, let's see. Unit 1, blah, blah, blah. That's your first assignment. Okay, let's look at Unit 1. All right, so in Unit 1, and again, this is kind of repetitive. I've got the Unit 1 reading assignments. You can find them here as well. You click on that, and then you click on this, and it'll bring up the reading assignment. So it's fairly easy, straightforward. And then there are some video assignments, some good videos to watch right there. And then here's learning objectives right there. There'll be those. And then here is the test. Test 1, what is integrated pest management? This first test is not due until January 23rd at midnight, okay? Tuesday, January 23rd at midnight. The test, let me open up this test here. you can start the test, and then, you know, if you don't finish it, you can save it later. You can take this test twice. If you do take it twice, I'll average your two test grades on there. So if you take it the first time and you don't do so hot, you know, take it again and try to improve on your grade. So that's where the test lives. The tests are a combination of multiple choice, true, false. There will be some short answer. And then there'd be some essay questions too. And everything is out of the book. Okay. Everything's out of the book. So that's where the test is. And each unit has a test. All right. So here's Unit 2 reading assignments, and then your test right there. And then here's some weed videos. And down here, I've got some weed ID flashcards. Those things live down here. So if you want to practice on your weed pictures, you can use that. That's through Quizlet right there. That's integrated in there. Further down here, Unit 3. And I spell out when the test is due on each one. Again, reading assignments and videos and some interesting things right there. So all the units are set up the same way. There are one or two tests in each unit. Unit 4, keeping plants healthy. Keeping plants healthy is a cornerstone of integrated pest management. And Unit 4 reading assignments, and there are two tests, okay, in this unit. So be on the lookout for that. All right, so all the units have tests. And that's about it. Again, it's a lot of reading. Be sure and watch the videos. I do pull some questions off the videos, but nothing too tricky or anything. You do get to take the test twice. And like I said, if you have any questions, shoot me an email. I try to get back to you as soon as I can. Sometimes if I'm at my computer, I'll get right back to you. Okay. And if whatever reason you don't hear from me or something crazy, get a hold of Heather too, because she'll will get a hold of me as well. I will be posting. I'll be making recordings, talking about all this stuff, and posting those as well. So, well, thank you very much, and enjoy the course.